Lee, can you sum up what's a very disappointing afternoon for Rangers?
Well, yeah, that's it. You've used the word there. We obviously are disappointed and we're hurting in there. But like I try and say whenever I come and speak with yourselves or the press, that we can't afford to go away sulking. The obvious heartache, the obvious disappointment, we know that. But we need to quickly realise that we need to be better for today. We'll go away. Sometimes it's hard to, but we're sitting there and we're sitting after the game for an hour and a half and we sit and talk about problems and how we should be better, what we needed to do better in the game, the problems that occurred in the game. It's a lot. It's obviously said in the aftermath and the tense aftermath of the game and the obvious disappointment as I've just referred to. So we'll go away and we'll obviously look at the game, analyse it, and then leading into the next game we'll hopefully try and learn and be better for it. But there's clearly everybody in that dressing room's hurting and it's not a nice place now.
You've had the odd bump in the road along the way since the manager's come in, but you've always responded really well. Does that give you confidence to respond from this blow?
Yeah, well, that's one, as I said, as I always say when I come out here, we're not going to be negative. We're not going to let this drag into our training, let this drag into our preparations for the following week, because we realise that, or we know that we need to get back winning games of football. We need to get back to our identity, our style, our way of playing, the style that's seen us get so much success last season, and that's what we need to get back to, and we can only get that by hard work. So as of the next time we report back in, we need to get together, we need to stay together, we need to work hard, and we need to get back to winning games of football.
What was your feeling at the start of the second half? Because you certainly seemed to start the second half really well.
Yeah, there was periods even in the first half. I mean, I'll always look for positives out of negative situations. So again, when I watch the game back, when I go home tonight, I might be wrong. But certainly in the aftermath and how I feel after the game and how we've spoke, there was small positives in the first half. Is that good enough for us? No, we know it's not good enough, but these are the things you need to look at, what we did well and why we done it. And I think if you're to take away, if you're to look at the things we've done well, it's when we were ourselves. We played one and two touch, limited touches, we played forward, we attacked fast, and we looked a threat, whereas we didn't get that enough today, and that's the real disappointment, because that's a big factor in how we play. And of course, the 15 minutes after half time, like you mentioned, obviously 2-1, we go in and we know we can still go on and win the game if we do what we do, and show a better level of performance in the second half. And for the first 15 minutes we thought we could get a goal, we could go on him in the game. It obviously didn't turn out to be like that, and it's disappointing, obviously.
Another positive perhaps, the first goal competitively for Joel Garner.
Yeah, of course, he's obviously coming here and wanting to do well for the club, and he's wanting to score goals. As a number 9, when you've got that jersey, you want to score goals, or anywhere across that front three you're wanting to, your input's got to be goals, of course. And Joe obviously be delighted that he's got that, but not delighted in the sense of the result, but he'll be happy that he can say that he's got his first goal for Rangers.